Thanks, ASAP. Welcome to Wake Up Missoula with your hosts, Scott Ramph.
And Noelle McVoy. Good morning, everyone. Happy Monday. We all hope that you had a lovely weekend. It was absolutely gorgeous.
It was great.
It was great.
Amazing.
Yeah, it was like a dream.
It was amazing.
It was dope. I'm really glad that spring and summer are on our way.
Yeah, but of course, you can expect your weather to get worse today because there is a wind advisory warning for today, which means that's probably why, since it's so clear right now, it's going to get all cloudy and all sorts of precipitation because you're expecting 70% chances of rain.
Well, and it was a nice, if you guys noticed the sunset, the sunrise this morning, it was a nice pink sky. And you know what they always say is sunset, it's like
pink sky at night, sailor's delight.
Pink in the morning. Sailors take warning. Pink at night, sailor's delight. Mm-hmm. It says pink in the morning. It's gonna be all windy.
Yeah, you say it differently from the way I say it.
I don't care.
Okay.
Good.
Okay, well, let's take a look at the weather right now. It is currently 36 degrees outside. You can expect it's gonna rain today, but your high is gonna be 56 and your low is gonna be 32. And you have a chance of snow happening as well. By Tuesday, it's gonna barely snow, but of course you have it's gonna be mostly cloudy with a high of 49, so we're gonna definitely get a little colder for your Tuesday. And then of course Wednesday it's back to being warm, and by Thursday you can expect the high to be 76 degrees.
Oh my goodness, is that? Yeah.
Is that
accurate?
Yeah, it's gonna be really nice and warm this Thursday, and it'll be great. It'll be a great time to go outside or be inside at work, but of course you're here with us today this morning. And of course you can find out more information by going to the National Weather Service.
Yeah. Yep, you totally can. Yeah. Oh, also, you guys, so usually I tell you the snow report, but since it's been so beautiful, we haven't had any new snow. So instead, I'm going to tell you when the last weekends are of all the ski hills. So Whitefish Mountain Resort, their last weekend is next weekend on April 10th. Over at Discovery, their last weekend is also April 10th. And then over in Snowbowl, their last weekend is also April 10th. And then Lost Trail, they ended over the past weekend that we just had, as well as Blacktail Mountain also ended over the past weekend we had. Yeah, so you've got one more weekend of skiing at or the closer ones to Missoula. But other than that, you're done. Enjoy the spring.
Yep. Yeah. But you know what's not done is Wake Up Missoula. We'll be continuing on throughout the summer and towards the end of the spring. But of course, it's still spring, even though in Montana it's like, oh, spring just passed by.
Yeah, I know.
So, but you want to find out more information, you go to wakeupmissoula.wix.com/wakeupmissoula. So nice, we made you write it out twice. You can find us on our Facebook page. You can follow us on Twitter.
You can follow MCAT on Twitter, Missoula Community Access Television. It's at MCAT TV Missoula. You can check us out on Facebook, and to find out more information about MCAT, check us out at MCAT.org.
Yep, and over the weekend it was a national, not national, but it was...
It was Mall Day.
It was a nonprofit appreciation day at the Southgate Mall, and of course I have this simple picture that I took this earlier Saturday morning when we were setting up while Noelle was in the bathroom.
Great.
Yep.
That's weird. I'm just kidding. But yeah, the mall also took a photo of me, but I haven't seen it yet. And then Sean came, one of the guys that...
One of the producers here.
One of the producers came and also took pictures of me, but I was done with photos by the end of that time. I was just like, no more pictures, please, no more pictures.
Yeah.
I've been here all day. But it was very long and boring, and it was hard.
When did Joel come by?
At 3.
He came at 3.
Our boss Joel came by at 3. Yep. So that was nice. It was nice to have some relief and someone to hang out with. Mm-hmm. But yeah, towards the end of the day. And it was empty too, like it was slow, everyone was outside. But it's
for
MCAT.
Was it a slow day?
I mean, people just weren't stopping. Like I stood up and would like say hi to groups of people that passed, definitely with kids, and no one would stop. Like I got like 4 or 5.
Wow.
Whereas last year, a ton of people stopped.
Hmm.
But I think it's because we were funny and fun. And this year I was grumpy and tired. It's okay.
Hell has no fury like Noelle, who's tired.
Yeah, it's very true.
Mm-hmm. Isn't that how the saying goes?
Hell hath no fury as a woman, like a woman who's been scorned, or as a woman scorned.
Or Noelle is tired.
Or is Noelle's tired. I'm pretty sure. It's
That's
both.
Probably better that way.
It's both. Yeah, it both means the same thing.
Yeah. It's like, I'm tired. It's like, sleep scorned me, and now I'm angry.
Yeah. I'm tired and scorned.
But of course, it is this month kicked off the Child Abuse Awareness Month.
Okay,
and of course, our very own Ron Scholl shot this the other week, and of course we're going to be putting this on the air. I think it's usually like Tuesday night, channel 190 at 10 p.m. But I'm not entirely sure, but this is mostly like kind of like late breaking type stuff. But this is basically a little taste of what you guys can see tomorrow night or sometime on MCAT or online. It'll probably be online, so you can go to our MCAT YouTube channel, MCAT TV.
Prevention of Child Abuse Movement for April. If anybody is a bobcat here, this blue is not your color. I just want to make sure you knew that right now. What I'd like to do first, before anything, is if we're here, if you're here because you believe child abuse is okay, raise your hand. That was your first test, you passed. Okay, the next thing I want you to do is repeat after me. 7, 2, 8.
7, 2, 8.
Kids.
Kids.
7, 2, 8, kids. 7, 2, 8, kids.
7, 2, 8, kids.
7, 2, 8, kids.
So there.
Oh, that was a very awkward
ending.
That was ending.
Like,
wow.
Yeah, it was like.
Guess it's over now.
She must be. She's probably still saying 7, 2, 8 kids.
I know. She was really getting that crowd pumped. Yeah. Way to go, Gina.
Yep. She. She's coming to MCAT a handful of times. I remember for sure. She's one of her producers. I want to say Heather Haig, her sister. Even though it's not
Heather
right.
Haig, her
Heather
sister.
Heather Haig. I'm just like totally
Heather's
blanking
married.
On her sister. Huh?
Heather's married.
Yes.
I don't know.
Noelle Haig. Her name's Noelle Haig.
Yeah.
Yeah. But of course, we do have some new programming on tonight as well. So I'm going to talk a little bit about what's happening. There's the Presidential Lecture Series, which is an ongoing series where the university invites people from all over, all walks of life to come down and talk about all sorts of wonderful things that impact the world locally, not locally, all sorts of great stuff.
Mm-hmm.
There's... Then, of course, there's Stand Together Against Hate and Violence, which was a rally that was at Karis Park about a month ago. And, of course, Ron did get some video of it not too, so long
nice.
Ago. And it's going to be premiering tomorrow night on MCAT.
Great.
And then, of course, we have Global Public Health, which basically talks about, you know, Doctors Without Borders and their experience in other countries.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I've kind of like assumed. That's basically what they always talk about.
Yeah.
It's like it's doctors who go to another countries. And they come back here and talk about it.
Yeah, pretty much talk about health conditions in other countries.
That's what I've always seen from Global
yeah.
Public Health. It's
well, and it does say Global Public Health, so it's
yeah.
kind of like...
And also, like, big issues with, like, clean water. Clean
mm-hmm.
water is always a good... Like, one of the things is, like, if you want to, like, solve all the problems in a lot of countries, provide them clean water, and everything just kind of, like, eventually solves itself.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But, of course, without further ado, here's a little taste of what you guys can expect on MCAT, channel 189, tonight and tomorrow night.
We managed to get a logging ban in the High Himalaya with the recognition that the main function of the forest in the high mountains is conservation of water and soil, not the provisioning of timber. And since I was doing this voluntary work for CHIPCO, at the same time when I was also exploring the foundations of quantum theory with a PhD in fascinated that a colleague here has also worked on locality and non-locality in quantum theory. It was from CHIPCO I was learning the interconnectedness in nature of forests, of rivers, of people.
No matter who they are, how and where they grew up, the color of their skin, or their religious origins, that we see a reflection of the divine. The Hebrew Bible, the Torah says, Vayomer Elohim, na'aseh Adam b'tzalmenu ki demutenu. God said, let us make a human in our image, after our likeness. Let us hope that when we see the other person, we see this likeness of holiness in each other. And it reminds us to be good to each other. And it reminds us to care for each other. And it reminds us to be deeply kind.
Sometimes we work under adverse conditions. Lights go out mid-operation. Everybody dons a headlight. When I first went down and I was using all their equipment, this little dark spot right here, you'll be happy to know, is a part of the sterile sheets, but I'll give you a close-up. Oh. That was sterilized in the sheets. So it's a little adverse, but nowadays we have all this equipment down there. We've built a shed at the Save the Children facility. We keep equipment down there. We take new equipment.
Yeah, so that's what you guys can expect tomorrow night and tonight on MCAT.
Oh.
And of course, there is a lot of videos I have to show, but we're going to save that a little bit later today. We have a video that was from our Saturday drop-ins.
Oh, great.
But we'll show that towards the end of the episode. But right now, we're going to switch gears, and we're going to go over to Noelle's segment.
Oh, gosh. Maybe. I'm sneezing a lot. Every time I sneeze, it's not just like one sneeze, it's like six sneezes
it's like
in a row.
It's like it just has to get
all
out
there. Always consecutive, yeah.
Uh-huh.
Hey, Missoula, what's up? Happy Monday. I almost said Wednesday. Okay, this is what's going on in your community. All right, so starting today, as you all know, it is spring break. So all the kids are out there, all the college kids are out. We're all like, woo, spring break. And it's a beautiful week for spring break. It's pretty awesome. So this is what's going on in your community to get you busy and get you out there and give you things to do other than school. Over at Ms. Mo Gymnastics at 9:30, it's family fun time. It's an open gym for ages walking to 12 years. They have obstacle courses, trampolines, foam pits, all that fun stuff. Over at the Missoula Public Library, they've got open hours in their makerspace at 11, from 11 to 2:30. You can go in there, work on a project of your choice, and learn how to use equipment. Over at Roots Acro Sports Center, they have preschool playgroup. It's $8 drop-in, $12 for siblings. And parents and children get to choose the activities that they interest them the most. And it's ages walking to 5 years. They rotate. Over at Montgomery Distillery, it's their Moscow Monday, so a dollar from each cocktail sold goes to a nonprofit in the area. Bridge Group is at the Missoula Senior Center, also at 1. This is the Beginners Brush Up Group. And then also at 1 is the Duplicate Bridge Group. That is a Garden City Duplicate Bridge Club. Call them 241-1499 for more information.
It's like the Bizarro Bridge Group.
Yeah, I don't even know. Okay, and then over at Taste Buds Kitchen, they've got a Spring Break Around the World camp for ages 9 to 13. It starts at 1 p.m. It's $190 to $5 per week or $45 per day, and they're going to be making dishes from around the world. Over at the Missoula Public Library, they've got their electronics exploration from 3 to 6 in the makerspace. It's pretty much like their open drop-in time. You work on a project of your choice, and you get to learn how to use their equipment. There's Wordplay over at the base at the Warehouse Mall. It starts at 4. This is poetry, improv, playing with words, learning new words, vocabulary. But it's all fun. Yeah, starts at 4. 725 West Alder. And it's in the Warehouse Mall. Over at the Top Hat Lounge, they've got Raising the Dead, the live recorded shows of the Grateful Dead. This is from the 60s, 70s, 80s, and 90s. They've got audio show, trivia, happy hours, you know, drink specials. And over at Plunk is their service industry night at 6. So if you work in the service industry, you can, tell them that, and they'll give you an exclusive appetizer on deals, or exclusive menu on deals and appetizers.
You know what you're talking about.
I know. My brain is working faster than my mouth is. Okay, and then also at the base, right after their wordplay, they've got an open mic poetry reading. Starts at 6 p.m., so you can go in there and check that out and hear some poetry.
Yeah, because, you know, at first you have to do a little bit of a wordplay before you get into the sultry sounds of poetry.
You really do, yeah.
Right?
It's right after wordplay, 6 or 7 or 8.
That's kind of like works for everything. Mm-hmm. You have to do a little play. And then you get into it.
Yeah, then you get into it. I know. I think that's great. I like it. I mean, I honestly might go if I ever have Monday off. Yeah. Okay, so over at the Missoula Public Library, they've got computer fundamentals at 6. Registration is required. You can call 721-2665. But it's pretty much learning how to use your computer. It's just the basics, how to turn it on, what folders are, managing your desktop. Scott's definitely laughing
right next to me. At least it's not computer fundamentals for women.
At least it's not.
That's ridiculous.
Okay, so over at Unity of Missoula, they are located at 546 South Avenue West. They are going to be having a free 9-part film series called The Truth About Cancer by Ty Bollinger. So it'll be on consecutive Monday evenings through June 6th, except for Memorial Day. So the movie that is today at 7 p.m. is called True History of Chemotherapy and Pharmaceutical Monopoly. And then I've got a couple more events for today. John Rosette and Company is going to be at the Redbird Wine Bar at 7. It's going to be an evening of jazz from 7 to 10 for free. And then Blues Monday is at the Badlander at 9. So that's what's going on in your community on Monday. Up next, we've got a staff segment.
First of all, I want to wish happy birthday to Doris Day. Yesterday was her birthday, April 3rd. And she's 92.
Wow.
And she's probably best known for singing the song, Que Sera, Sera, for people who may not remember her. And she lives with her dogs these days. I mean, you know, Hollywood just says wonderful things about this lady. Anyway, before there was Jennifer Lopez playing our guest and Edward James Olmos, who's a fine actor in his own right, there was Selena Quintilla Perez, known to the world as Selena. And you know you've arrived in the entertainment business when you are a one-name entertainer like Madonna, Cher, Liberace, and of course, Selena. Yow, baby! Anyway, Selena was an American singer, songwriter, spokesperson, actress, and a fashion designer. She accomplished a lot in the short time that her star rose, and she's called the Queen of Tejano Music. Her contributions in the music industry and the fashion made her the most celebrated Mexican-American entertainer of the 20th century. Billboard magazine named her the top Latin artist of the 90s and the best-selling Latin artist of the decade, the 90s. She's also called the Tejano Madonna for her clothing choices. And I just think that's just amazing to accomplish that much in her life. She, of course, is from Corpus Christi, Texas. She comes from a modest family as far as humble beginnings, and she started singing as a child, did, you know, talent shows and things like that, and she wound up becoming probably one of the best entertainers in history. And had her star not dimmed out, no telling what this young woman would have accomplished in the Tejano music world and, of course, in the English world. For example, her album release, Amor Prohibido, in 1994, it became the best-selling Latin album in the United States. Just that one album alone. Not to mention the albums that she's done in the Spanish language, too. So she was able to not only do the Spanish music, but cross over into the United States as far as, I call it the English version, I guess. And when we lost her, George W. Bush, the governor of Texas at that time, declared her birthday Selena Day in Texas. And of course, after her passing, her crossover album, Dreamin' of You in 95, debuted at the Billboard 200, making Selena the first Latin artist to accomplish this feat. Isn't that something? The first one in history. And of course, there was a film about her with the actress Jennifer Lopez called Selena. And Selena has sold over 60 million albums worldwide. That's an amazing feat for the short time that we were blessed to have this young woman. So finally, let's show this goodbye clip of our guest.
The positive lifestyle and joyous moments that Selena brought to millions will endure forever in the hearts of her fans, her friends, her fellow artists, and her beloved family.
Hmm. My final words about her, first of all, my condolences to Selena's family and of course, the fans that loved her. Selena's message to the youth of America and her fans and her music, what it spoke for, stay in school, stay off drugs, be the best you can be at whatever you're doing. And that's a wonderful legacy to leave behind.
Yeah, she was awesome.
Yes, she was.
Thanks, Asaph.
Thanks, Asaph. Sure.
That was Notes with Asaph Adonai.
And we'll be right back after this art clip from the Missoula Art Museum.
Hey guys, we're back. This is what's going on in your community on Tuesday. All right, lots of things happening. Okay, so starting at 9 a.m. Over at Currents Aquatic Center, they've got their winter walking tours and coffee meets. They're all gonna meet up and then they're gonna go over to Cherry Gulch and hike. It's only $5. Over at Taste Buds Kitchen, they've got their Spring Break Around the World camp for ages 4 to 8, and then their older camp for ages 9 to 13 is later in the day at 1 o'clock, and this is every day this week. So it's $195 for the week or $45 just to drop in. We've got Family Fun Time at the Y over at the YMCA starting at 9:30. There's lots of things for parents and children. The children have softy hockey, scooters, lots of different activities they can do. And then the parents get comfy couches and chairs to just chill on. Over at the Missoula Public Library, they've got open hours in the makerspace at 10. So from 10 to 6, you can go in there, learn how to use the equipment, or work on a project of your choice. And then over at the Missoula Public Library, last week I talked about how they had a library peeps show contest where you can make a diorama and make some interesting shows or interesting scenes with peeps. And so tomorrow's the deadline. Tuesday's the deadline. So if you haven't made your thing, do it today and then drop it off and they'll display them all week long. Over at the public library, they've got Tiny Tales at 10:30. This is for babies ages birth to 3 years to sing songs and hear nursery rhymes and finger plays and hear stories. There's face painting at the Children's Museum of Missoula at 11. And then over in the Alps Boardroom is Shootin' the Bull Toastmasters at 12. This is a lively Toastmasters club where you can grow your vocabulary, increase your public speaking skills, and become effective a leader. Over at the Montana Distillery, they've got the Mule-tastic Tuesdays. $1 from each cocktail sold will go to the nonprofit in the area. And then over at the Clay Studio of Missoula, from Tuesday to Friday, all week long, is a Spring Break Teen Wheel Throwing Intensive. This is from 11 to 18 years old. There's a 12:30 to 2:30. And so they'll learn about basic wheel throwing techniques as well as processes for glazing and firing.
So throw those wheels, people.
$85 per child with a $5 discount for members. This includes all materials and firings. Final glaze projects will be available for pickup 2 to 3 weeks after the final session, which will be Friday. So call 543-0509 to sign up. Yoga Warriors is at the Learning Center at Red Willow at 4. This is a yoga program that's designed for veterans and their families to help with sleeping and anxiety and PTSD. over at the Zootown Arts Community Center, starting at 4 every Tuesday, they've got Tune Up Tuesdays, and it's for your child to come in, to drop in, bring their instrument, and just rock out. So, you know, if they don't have a place to practice, or they're in your garage, and maybe you need to park your car, you can bring them over to the Zootown Arts Community Center. They can rock out on Tuesdays, starting at 4. And so it's not any instruction, it's just time for them to practice. Over the University of Montana, at the James E. Todd Building, they have an Introduction to Advertising Concepts at 5:30. So it provides you with a practical understanding of how to create messages that cut through the clutter of today's crowded media markets and learn the basics of advertising concepts. That'd probably be a good thing to go to. Over at the Learning Center Red Willow, they've got a Releasing Anxiety class at 6. This is from April 5th to May 10th, starting from 6 in the afternoon to 7:30. And it's a 6-week course, $140. And so you'll learn practical mind-body tools for restoring a comfortable connection to your own life energies and emotions. I hope you release anxiety. Over at the Top Hat Lounge, we've got Picking Circle from 6 to 8 every Tuesday. Bluegrass-oriented musicians are invited to go down there and jam out in the raised seating booth in front of the sound area. So, you know. Over at the Public Library, they've got System Check. This is the official gamers club for ages 19 and under. And then at the Good Food Store, they're making hands-on pizza, $35 to go in there and learn how to make your own pizza from scratch. Over at the Roxy Theater, they've got the Met Live in HD, the Madame Butterfly Encore. And so it is, let's see, what they do is they film the Met and then they make it into like a movie. So it's pretty much, it's like a movie about a play, but it's Madame Butterfly. And if you guys do not know what this story is, it's about a geisha who falls in love with a naval officer and he breaks her heart. What a jerk.
Yeah.
I hate guys. I really do. Okay, so, but if you guys don't want to sit down and you want to do some active things, here's some active adult things you can do tomorrow night. So starting at 7 over at the Barn Movement Studio, they've got ULA, $4 drop in or $10 a month for unlimited access. You can call 317-1214. They're located at 2926 South 3rd Street West. There's African dance class over at the Missoula Senior Center at 7. $10 per class or $35 for 4 classes. And then over at Mismo Gymnastics is adult trampoline and tumbling starting at 7:30. Anyone 12 and up in all ability levels can go there. $10 for a member, $15 for non-members. And then we have our adult TNT over at Roots Acro Sports Center from 7:30 to 8:30, 16 and up, and it's $8 to drop in. You just jump around and fly around and get crazy. So as always, check out MissoulaEvents.net, the University of Montana, the Independent, or the Missoulian for more events in Missoula. Yeah. Let's see, where are we? Uh-oh.
No, we're good.
Okay, good. Yeah. I thought I pressed something wrong. That happens sometimes.
All right, so we do have a video I've been telling people I wanted to show, and it's, I don't know how to describe it exactly, but I might as well just show it. So here is a nice little live-action video made by our Stop Animation Drop-In on Saturdays. I know, that's a lot, like a long title for, like a long introduction, but without further ado, here it is.
So I met this girl, and like, I ate her brains, and it tasted funny. It just didn't taste right at all.
What do you mean, like, it didn't taste right?
It just didn't taste right to me. It just felt weird eating the brains.
Did you add the salt?
Of course I added the salt.
Because you gotta add salt.
Hey, guys! We sure did have a crazy day.
We sure did.
Sorry, we forgot. Well, so today, I forgot to tell you guys, but today I ate a girl's brain steak. Just didn't taste right at all. And my friend here asked if I added salt, and I did, but it still didn't taste right. So, yeah.
That's gross.
That's not gross.
It's natural.
Okay, I don't know what world you guys are from, but we humans don't eat brains.
You gotta try it sometime, man. It's actually pretty good.
I better go to my new job.
Oh,
We'll see you guys! Hey, stop the bitch!
I'm just so hungry. I haven't eaten brains in almost a week.
But you just said you ate a girl's brains today.
Yeah, sorry. It's just really hard to remember things when you're a zombie.
Why do you guys only talk about brains?
They're good, man.
They're a very nutritious breakfast.
Have you ever had a steak? Anything but brains?
Well, I ate this guy's ribs once. That was delicious. Does that count?
Something other than humans? You can do that?
Yes!
Whoa! That just blew my rotting brain!
Hello, zombie field.
Hello, werewolf.
I just wanted to tell you that I lost your issue of Human Brain Weekly.
Werewolf! I seriously do not like that guy one bit.
Yeah, me neither.
He doesn't even eat brains. He just eats people.
Lots of people don't eat brains or humans!
Well, I gotta see you guys later. I got a hot date with Phoenix.
Smoking.
Wow, what a crazy day. I hope Phoenix likes brains.
Of course, there's that.
What? Why didn't you show the credits?
Because it takes forever to
they're
show.
Hilarious.
That's like half the video is the credits.
Oh, they're funny. Harrison Ford as Tom Cruise as himself, Batman as Ben Affleck, Neil Patrick Harris as Darth Vader. Ooh, gosh, they had a lot of really good actors in this movie. I had no idea.
Well, we didn't see them all. They must have been playing like a plant in the background.
Yeah, cameos or extras. I just love those kids. They're my favorites. Aw. Cute!
And then the day you come back, they're not
I know,
back.
I know, and the day I come back. I know, the past two weeks I haven't been at camp because I've had a weekend off and then I had to be at the mall. And two of my favorite kids, the main two, have been coming and I haven't even been there. Oh well, they're cool though, they're cool kids.
Well, guys,
I think that's it.
It's a nice kickoff for the rest of the work week. Yeah. We have, if you're interested in making a program on MCAT, we have our orientation every second Wednesday of the month. So you can expect that to happen on April 14th.
Next Wednesday.
Next Wednesday. Not this Wednesday, but the following Wednesday.
It should be, I think it's, yeah, April 14th, because the Saturday is that 10th.
Of course, yes. I have this hilarious video on a show before we go.
So funny.
And, it follows the adventures of a cat who's obsessed with boxes. Here it is. You put a box right in front of the cat, and the cat just dives headfirst into it.
He loves it. I just love how much he loves it.
He just loves those boxes.
Yeah, and that flat little face is so cute. He's so big. He's a huge cat. It's a
it is MCAT, and of course, if we don't show some kind of cat
that
video.
Yeah.
I know, it's like literally like my favorite video.
It's so funny. I love that. That's like our mascot.
It's like, oh man, it's just so funny. I just can't handle it.
I know, anymore. I can't either.
I've just been watching that all weekend long.
It's so funny. It's cute. Well, I just love that he like, I just wonder what he like gets out of that, you know, like, and how he discovered it and what goes through his little cat mind as he does it. He's just like, this is awesome. This is so much fun. This is super great.
Yeah.
Because his tail wags and he's all big and his face is all flat. Oh God, he's cute. So cute.
I just wanted to show that before we left. Of course, you can find out where you can find our... Let's start this again. You can find out more information about Wake Up Missoula by logging on to our website, wakeupmissoula.wix.com/wakeupmissoula. Sometimes you made your write out twice. You can see current episodes, past episodes, and interviews, along with other special Flagship Friday, the stop animation video of the week. And of course, you can always go to our Facebook page where we post everything that we've shown you guys, along with our Twitter.
Yeah.
At Wake Up Missoula.
And you can check out Missoula Community Access Television on Twitter, where we always tweet. We tweet Wake Up Missoula's morning shows and all the things that are going on at Missoula Community Access Television. And you can check us out on Facebook, where we also post pictures and videos of the things that we do at our television station. Yep. And then to find out more information about us, to check us out on our website, you can find out our channels. Just go to MCAT.org.
And of course, if you are interested in being on our show, you can call us at 542-6228, otherwise known as 542-MCAT. Or you can email us MCAT@MCAT.org to talk about an upcoming event, rally, or cause. Or if you're doing a concert, it's always great to get musicians here, mm-hmm. even though it's hard for them to wake up in the morning. They're musicians, except if you're ASAP.
Except for ASAP. ASAP's the only musician that is really dedicated. Yeah. You guys are all posers.
That's like really mean.
Okay.
But without further ado, we leave you on this mean note, musician.
Yes, we leave you
on this. So for Wake Up Missoula, I'm Scott Ramph.
And for Wake Up Missoula, my name is Noelle McFoy. Here's ASAP Adonai.